What's up, everybody? My name's Steve. Came up with a YouTube channel called Vortec Five Speed. It's gonna be my second video. Currently getting off of work right now, and I'm sorry, trying to take off the emergency brake on my foot. Chingo. I purchased a subwoofer box for my 2005 Chevy Silverado single cab over a month ago, and it shows to be going to be shipped today, and I'm very stoked. Reason why I'm so happy about it, because it's purposely designed to fit a 99 to 2006 earlier model 2007 Silverado. And it's designed so perfectly that it doesn't move around or teeter totter on the hump on the back. So I'm pretty excited to go see this box. This is gonna be a short clip, because reason why I came up with the name Vortec 5-speed is because I drive a 5-speed V8 Silverado. I'll tell you guys more about the little things that I've done to it, like the sunroof. That's one of the things that I've done. The center console is another thing that I've done. This vehicle wasn't specifically made with the center console. All right, guys, well, I'm gonna cut this video short. Once I get better with the editing and everything like that, then I'll make a good video. So I'm gonna cut this one right here.
Nos llegó el paquete. Vamos a ver qué pedo. Ay, ay, ay. Ta-da! Mira nomás.
Qué bonito, ¿se mira? Good morning, y'all. Back with one other video for the installation of the box that we're going to be doing. Let's see if you can check it out. Oh, be installing this new box. See Silverado right here. It's actually made for this specific year of truck. I don't know if you guys had any trouble putting boxes in that slide or lean forward, ruin your space on your seat. Finally got it. Gonna install it. Gonna make a short video for you guys of me installing it. Gotta remove the seats, take the other speaker box out, clean up a little bit, and take it from there. Catch my Instagram page, Vortec 5-speed. I'll give you guys a little preview on what I gotta do in here. Okay, so gotta remove the seats. Take whatever I have in here to install it. The old box. Es que tomo un chingo de agua. Y luego, gotta remove this box. It just freaking moves around everywhere. I'll show you guys. Tengo pinche desmadre. Pero this is actually for an extended cab when I got the speakers. So we'll see how it goes. Alright, so we're gonna be, our duty of today is gonna be installing this box here. I wanted to take my time and do this video especially for y'all. So we're gonna go step right over here and start desmadrando la camioneta, quitarle todos los asientos. And then the people that don't speak Spanish, we're gonna take off all the seats to remove the other box, to transfer the amplifier here in the center. We're gonna install the 10-inch JL audio subwoofers here. And we're gonna begin by taking off the seats. Aquí tenemos la herramienta que nos hace la vida muy fácil. I have a really sensitive alarm, as y'all can see. So, prendí la llave, pues para hacer mi ruido y que no prenda la alarma. Quitar el primer asiento y lo ponemos ahora para el otro lado. Desconectar la bolsa de aire. Okay, as you guys can see, I have a very small box that don't belong in here. This one actually here belongs to a four-door. So now I gotta transfer all the speakers, the amplifiers, and the epicenter to the other box. So that's another task for right now. Pretty same in color. It's pretty cool because I like the color on this old box here. Now you can see the shape difference. Now how this is gonna work. So we'll continue the process now. Currently taking this bracket slash connector because for the amount of money I paid, apparently wasn't enough to actually give me some for the new box, so I have to transfer them over. So So I've got to find a way to kind of cut this out here so I can install these here so I can connect the subwoofers. Taladro chingón aquí. I'll cut this side out. Doing a test fit on how it fits, and I gotta say I'm really happy on how this sits. It sits pretty flush. It has these legs here. They can still have your floor jack here. Obviously the tools that sit about here, you have to take them out, but the design of this box is perfect. As you can see, it's very sturdy. These legs really help out because of this hump that it has here. So right now I'm just, since I didn't have this box before, I gotta redirect some wiring, since before my connections were on the right side, which is the passenger side of the vehicle. Now it's sitting on the left side, so now I gotta find a way to move them over for them to sit well. I decided to mount the amp kind of low so it doesn't sit too high, because there's a blue light when you turn it on, so at nighttime I'm gonna have a blue light coming from the back reflecting towards the front of the vehicle, the truck. And then I have an epicenter, which I think I'm just gonna leave here, since the center console actually covers it, since I don't want to have too much going on this amp space here besides just the amp. So this one I gotta find a ground somewhere else, since the wire is not long enough. And then the positive and the remote, they're long enough. I just gotta find a way to run them neatly back to the left side of the truck and connect them to the amplifier here. Perdón, miren la panza. Me gustan los tacos, las tortas, los burritos, las cervezas, y todo lo que engorde. So we'll get redirected and connect it and turn it on and see how it goes. See you back in a second. All right, so I finished connecting it. Obviously it's probably not the best job, but you know, when you go to a radio shop, they have all the equipment, all the extra cables that you need. And so for now, this is how it's gonna stay. It works great, sounds really good. I'm really happy on how, the way it looks and the way it sits, the way the legs hold the box up. This is gonna be about the last of the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And I gotta say that this setup now looks malas nalgas. And if y'all don't know what malas nalgas is badass. So see you guys on the next one.